Hello and welcome to Know Your Faith series. I am Collins, and today we'll be talking about the different oils in the church and their uses. Throughout the Bible, there are various references that indicate the importance of the use of the olive oil. We see in the book of Numbers 11, from verses 7 to 9, that it can be used in cooking, especially for bread. It can be used as a lamp, as you see in Matthew chapter 25, from verses 1 to 9, and as a healing agent in Isaiah chapter 1, verses 6. The scripture also attests to the spiritual symbolism. That is, we see that the oil is actually used in the anointing of a king or a priest. There are three types of oils used in the church: the oil of the sick, the oil of the catechumen, and the chrism oil. And today I'll be sharing with you the different uses of these oils. On Holy Thursday morning, the bishop, together with all the priests in the diocese, come together to celebrate the chrism mass. And here at this mass, the bishop blesses all the oils that would be used for the entire year. So the first oil is the oil of the sick. The oil of the sick is a pure olive oil, which is used for the sacrament of the anointing of the sick. Now, this sacrament is a sacrament that can be admonished at any time and at any place. Usually for someone who is in a very bad state health-wise, who is very, very sick, and usually administered by a priest. So the priest dips his hand in the oil and places a sign of the cross on the forehead of the sick person. The second oil is the oil of the catechumen. Now, this oil is also a pure olive oil and is usually used pre or before baptism, both for adults and young people. So we see that in the Easter Vigil Mass, that's before the rite of the Christian initiation for adults, the catechumens are signed or are touched with the oil of the catechumen. And also the young infant before baptism is also touched with the oil of the catechumen. And the final oil is the oil, is the holy chrism oil. Now, this oil is actually consecrated. Now, like I explained earlier, the other two oils are actually blessed at the chrism mass, while this particular oil is consecrated. The olive oil in this case is mixed with balsam, and it symbolizes strength, and the fragrance represents the aroma of Christ, as we see in 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 15. So, anointing with the chrism oil signifies the Holy Spirit, and it is used to consecrate someone or something to Christ. So, even during the consecration of priests, we use the chrism oil for during confirmation, where the bishop lays his hands on the forehead of the catechumen, says his name, and uses the sign of the cross to confirm the Christian as a soldier of Christ. And you'd want to ask, what about the regular olive oil? Well, the regular ones that you take to your priest to bless for you can be seen as just a sacramental, like the way the rosary and the chaplet and other sacramentals are. So you can also use them in your homes. But however, the three major oils in the church are the oil of the sick, the oil of the catechumen, and the holy chrism oil. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you for joining us. I hope you learned a couple of things. Please feel free to like, subscribe, and comment, and also share this content. Till I come your way next time, be bold and be Catholic.